Hey guys, it's Somir and today I'm going to show you what I just built over the last 1 week. So don't go mad at searching for each of the components. I'm going to make your life easy and put all the links below in the video description so you can just go ahead and get it. Happy shopping! I'm not a Windows guy, absolutely not. The day I got an Apple computer back in 2009, I haven't looked back. I mean, Windows life is so terrible. I edit all of my videos on my 2017 MacBook Pro, and I've already done a video of my home office where I did show how I'm editing all of my stuff using this MacBook Pro connected to a LG 4K monitor, and it just runs so smooth. In case you have missed the video, here is the link, go ahead and check it out. Now coming back to the point about this last week build, this is a Windows editing rig built solely for the purpose of video editing and video rendering. So I have a small production company for last 8 years now, and my team does a bunch of projects all around the year. So this machine is built for them. I mean, technology is like changing every day. So if you don't have a compatible hardware with you, you are absolutely dead. And my teams have been using my Intel based rigs for last 6 years now, and those machines still run like boss. But lately I have been hearing good things about this AMD Ryzen and about its performance, good performance with the Adobe Premiere Pro, which we need. So I just went ahead and got this done. Oh yes, gamers in my list, if you are waiting for some gaming visuals or gaming tests, that's not going to happen. I am just someone who is not into gaming at all. Sorry about it, sorry to disappoint. Well, so enough of talks, I guess. Let me just show you what all components did I use to get this bad boy ready. Like it? I love it. Let's just go ahead and talk about the components. For the motherboard, I went for this Asus B350 Plus. So this is a AMD based motherboard and is really loaded. This is one of the best motherboards you can get for any of the AMD Ryzen processors, and is loaded with like 3 USB 3.0 ports, 2 USB 2.0 ports, and a lot of IO ports, whatnot. And this supports DDR4 RAM and does up to like 64 GB of RAM with 4 slots. You can put like 16, 16, 16, 16. That makes like 64 GB of RAM. Huge for the price paid. The only drawback is it just have got like 4 SATA ports. So if you are looking to install more than 4 hard drives, you need to look for the other motherboard. I mean the next possible motherboard from Asus series. For the processor, I went for this infamous AMD Ryzen 1700. So this is the cheapest 8-core processor you can get right now from AMD arsenal. The reason I have gone for AMD Ryzen over the Intel processor is AMD Ryzen has the best possible reviews for Adobe Premiere Pro, for which is like multi-threaded application. But if you're someone into gaming, I do not recommend AMD Ryzen. You need to go for Intel based processor because Ryzen do not have good reviews for single threaded application like gaming. But for multi-threaded like video rendering, video editing, this is absolutely amazing. The base clock speed is like 3 GHz, and you can also boost each of its core to like 3.7 GHz. That is really huge for the price paid. And Intel 8 core processors are really amazing as well. I mean, when it comes to gaming, no one can beat Intel. But the issue with Intel is they're really expensive and draws a lot of power. For example, this Ryzen is just drawing like 60 or 65 watt, while the Intel 69XX lineup of processors are drawing like 140 watts, really huge. Then for the graphics card, which is the heart of operations and performance, I went for this Asus GeForce GTX 1070 8GB Turbo Edition. This is like 4K ready and VR ready as well. It has like 2 HDMI ports, 1 display port and other ports. It is extremely power friendly and quiet. I mean, if you are editing or rendering a 4K video, you do not hear all those fan sounds like absolutely quiet. The only drawback is it doesn't do 4K at 60 FPS. So if you are someone who is into hyper gaming, you need to go for the 1080. And for the RAM, I went for those Corsair Vengeance series 32GB, 16GB, getting into two slots on the motherboard, making it 32GB. I mean, Corsair Vengeance series has been my go-to RAM modules for years now. Almost all of my editing rigs have those same Corsair Vengeance series RAM. I mean, I can blindly trust them whenever it comes to resource-hungry applications like Adobe Premiere Pro, After Effects, any of those kind. I mean, Corsair Vengeance series never ever fails. Now, talking about the storage for the OS drive, I use a Samsung 960 EVO NVMe PCIe based SSD. This thing is amazingly fast and its read write is up to like 3200 to 1500 MB per second. Amazingly fast. The best thing is it comes with 3 years replacement warranty. Then for the storage of my files and stuff, I'm keeping one Western Digital internal black, Western Digital black 4 TB, and then for the external SSD, I'm using a Samsung PM863 480 GB SSD where all those editing assets stay and gets edited into the Premiere Pro. So basically this thing is again very expensive, but it does the job so well. And about the power supply, I went for this Cooler Master V1000. So this is a gold rated power supply unit and I needed something of that high wattage because I'm looking to upgrade few components in the future. So like 1000 watt is really going to make sense here. If you are looking to make it really nice and sexy, then maybe go ahead and get some kind of RGB fan and LED lights. For the cooling of the processor, I went with this Cooler Master Hyper 212. Cooler Master Hyper 212 is hands down the best cooler you can buy at this price point right now. The only issue is the installation is a bit tricky. It takes some time and this thing is huge. You absolutely need a good case, good deep chassis for this to install. And if you are confused between a liquid cooler and this, just go ahead and get it. Save that extra 50% of money, maybe invest that on good storage. For the keyboard and mouse, as usual, I always prefer my wireless solar powered Logitech keyboard and mouse for all of my Windows systems and Apple computers. So it was no brainer, I just went ahead and got the same this time as well. I've already done a video about it, in case you have missed it, here is the link again. For the monitor, I went for this super huge LG ultra wide display. This is a 21:9 ultra wide display with resolution up to 3440x1440. Absolutely staggering resolution, but it's not 4K, it's just up to like 1080p and it's ultra wide. This is an IPS display with inbuilt speakers and I absolutely recommend getting this display if you are someone into pro gaming or pro video editing. I love this display. For the speakers, I use those M-Audio AV42 studio monitor speakers. Those speakers has been my go-to speakers for all kind of editing and stuff for almost like 1 or 2 years now. I absolutely recommend getting those AV42, or maybe if you don't have a budget, go ahead and get the AV32, but this thing is a beast. For the mouse pad, this is a huge world map. I always needed some kind of mouse pad like this. You can call this a double XL, triple XL mouse pad. I'm going to leave all the links below in the video description. I guess everyone is going to get this mouse pad. It looks so amazing. You can just move your mouse anywhere you like swimming all across your computers with your mouse. Then for the case, I went ahead and got this NZXT S340 case. This is a mid tower and I'm in so love with those NZXT design. I mean, matte black, completely black, unibody design made out of steel. This is amazingly good. And the best thing about NZXT is the cable management. You absolutely do not see any of the cables tangling inside those chassis like a spider web. I am in so insanely love with this case. And then for the OS, Windows 10 Professional 64-bit, licensed and paid, of course. So that's it guys, that's the whole list of components which I have used to build this massive video editing rig. If you are looking to build the same, I have left all the links below in the video description, just go ahead and get it. And if you have got any question, just let me know in the comment section below. Smash the subscribe button if you haven't done it yet, and don't forget to click on the bell icon to stay updated. I will see you next time. Peace.